It's time for the Family Feud, introducing the Taylor family. Brad, Jan, Patty, Craig, and Betsy, ready for action. And the Dixon family. Lita, Robert, Doris, Len, and Shirley. On your marks, let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
Well, there's a little girl here who looks just like Lisa, who gave me some maple syrup one day. Remember? One show we did, months ago we did this show. Look how pretty she is. Are you the same girl? Are you? That was so good. I made the pancakes and everything. It was so great. Nice to see you again, Lisa. We got $10,000 to give away here. The Taylors are here. Let's make them feel good.
Thank you.
Who's it down here?
Well, I'd like to introduce my sister, Jan.
Hi, Richard.
My sister, Patty.
Hi.
Hi, Patty.
Next to her is my brother-in-law, Craig.
Richard.
And he's married to my little sister on the end, Betsy.
Hi.
Hi, Betsy. You've got some great-looking sisters.
I think so.
Yeah. What do you do?
I'm a doctor.
Oh, could have I used you in Hawaii?
Well...
You'd have given me something for my tooth.
Well, I heard that you had a tooth problem. That's a little high. I'm a urologist.
Oh. I'm not touching that in a 10-foot pole. I'm in enough trouble. I'm going to make the Dixons feel at home. Hello, darling. Who do you got here?
Richard, I have my loving husband, Robert.
Hi, Robert.
Richard, how are
nice
you?
To have you here.
I have Robert's sister, Doris.
Hello.
Hello, Richard.
I have Robert Doris's husband, Lynn.
Hi, Richard.
Lynn.
And I have my sister-in-law, the baby sister to Robert, Shirley.
Hi, Richard.
Hi, Shirley.
I love your hair.
Thank you.
Isn't that pretty? How long does that take you to do your hair, Shirley?
3 hours.
3 hours? You can't do that yourself, huh? You
have I have someone do it for me.
You're so pretty.
Thank you.
Isn't that pretty hair? I love that. Yeah, that's gorgeous. Where do you live?
I live in Altadena, California.
Oh, do you?
Mm-hmm.
I've got a dairy there. I mean, I don't have one. They deliver milk.
Sure.
Yeah.
Which one?
Altadena Dairy.
Ah, that makes a lot of sense.
Well, that's the reason they put it there.
Uh-huh.
Come with me. Let's play the feud. Come on.
A lot of
dairies there? Oh, I thought
that's
it was
the one I have.
Here we go. Dear. I hope I never see you professionally, Doctor. 100 people surveyed. Top 7 answers are on the board. You have to try and get the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name something you can recognize by its smell when it's cooked. Yeah.
Boiled eggs.
Boiled eggs. This is a funny day today, I think. Something you can recognize by its smell when it's cooking.
Chili.
Chili. Later, you're going to tell me what boiled eggs smell like. Robert.
How about lamb?
Lamb, of course. What do you say we all go to the dentist? Right? Jan.
I'm going to say fish.
Fish. Fish. Okay.
We'll play.
In spite of those answers, I'll have to go. All right. I got to thank you for getting me in the game.
Thank you.
Hi, pretty.
Hi.
Something you can recognize by its smell when it's cooking.
Hamburger.
Hamburger? Up there. Craig?
Richard?
What do you think, sir?
Well, I'll stick with the meat. I'll say steak.
Steak. All right. We're looking for a steak.
Come on, Betsy.
Betsy, we're in a little trouble here. In a tiny bit of trouble. We got 2 strikes up there.
Okay.
Something you can recognize by its smell when it's cooking.
How about chicken?
Chicken? All righty.
Good answer.
Chicken's there okay. If not, 3rd strike. Chicken! No! I know it's embarrassing to ask you to get up for $12, but you have to do it.
Bacon! Bacon! Bacon!
chicken.
Richard, how can you not know the smell of bacon?
Well, why didn't you say that before?
I don't know.
Why'd you tell me boiled eggs before?
I'm sorry.
Bacon sounds like a great answer. If it's there, $12. If not, you get it, Brad. Bacon! One blade.
Cabbage.
Sauerkraut. Number three.
Onion.
Five.
Spaghetti.
Six.
Bread.
Seven.
Cake.
$12 there, nothing there. Come on, pretty drink. Nice to see you, Robert. 100 people surveyed. Top six answers are on the board. Here's the question. Name something associated with Alaska. Yes.
Eskimos.
One answer will beat them.
How about oil, Richard?
Player pass.
We'll play.
We're going to play, Richard.
Good. Okay, Richard, great.
Sure, the pipeline had to be there.
Okay.
Something associated with Alaska.
Cold weather.
Good.
Cold weather.
All right.
My old friend, the polar bear.
Ah. Polar bear. Bad news for you and your old friend.
Yeah.
Well.
Gold.
Gold?
Uh-huh.
Good answer.
Gold.
Good.
Gold. $2. Two answers left. Number one answer. What do you think it is, young Brad?
Igloos.
Igloos. All right. If it's there, all right. If not, second strike. Igloo!
Yeah, yeah.
You started this, and you can do it right now. Finish it off. Something associated with Alaska.
How about ice?
Ice, okay. Ice is there. You got it all. Nice way to start the game. If not, second strike. Ice! Not there. Okay.
Puppy. Alaska. Long days.
Long days?
Good answer.
Is there, you got it? If not? Okay. Long and short days. I'll give you both. Long and short days. $60 up there. You can get it. Come on.
Husky. Snow dogs.
Well.
Okay.
Richard will go with Alaskan Husky.
Huskies, all righty. The Husky's there, darling. You get the money, all the money. And why'd you get it over here? Husky! If snow is up there, they've still got it anyway because they said ice. But I'm surprised of you if snow was there and you didn't give them a ride. Show me number one. Well, you got the money anyway. It'll save me going to a higher court. We'll be back right after this. You're from Chicago.
Right.
What's your last name, Blair?
Punch Rilly.
Bless you. Now, what have you got? Something for my T-shirt collection?
We came all the way from Chicago to give you this T-shirt.
Well, let's show it on the camera here. So Chicago, my kind of town, which it is.
We have something special on
the back.
Chicago survey says Richard Dawson is number one.
Thank you, Blair. Of you. Thank you. Jenny, that's it. Thank you. $60 there, $12 there. Let's go. How are you, Jenny? Welcome. You just need one hand because there's a. Pop it there, whichever one you like. You comfy?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay. First family now get 300 points. We'll play for $10,000. 100 people surveyed. Top six answers are on the board. Here's the question. Name something pets do that makes their masters angry.
Wet on the carpet.
They wet. What are you going to do?
Okay, Richard, come here.
They play them all, don't they? It doesn't seem right. I never get to meet that side of the table. What do you do? Potty indoors. Something pets do that makes their masters angry.
They're disobedient.
Ah, okay. Disobedient.
They run away.
Oh. Good answer.
Departé.
I would say have unwanted litters.
Gotcha.
Good, good, Brad.
Mucho family. Up there, okay. It's your job, you see, gives you those sort of answers. Something pets do that makes them answers angry.
I have two answers.
Just give me one, you see, it's there.
They bark at people's friends when they come over. They bark at their friends when the friends come over.
As opposed to barking at enemies. Barking at friends.
Barking or biting?
Oh, fine, it's all right.
Okay.
They bark!
They jump up on people.
Yeah, they... I have a fish, you know, used to do that. Yeah, that little goldfish of mine. Drive me crazy. The moment someone came to visit me, would jump up on them. I could never break them of it. Oh, dear. They jump up on me. No, they don't. That's good. You were working on the dog theory, which is nothing wrong, because a lot of dog answers were up there. But I just want... The key word here is pets. Something pets
key
do.
Key word is pets. Well, we've had cats before. They ruin the furniture. They scratch.
Okay, fine.
Yeah.
Is there all right, Ray? If not, third's right. They scratch the furniture. I want you to see my producer's brain. He wouldn't give you snow for ice, but he'll give you scratch furniture by getting on it.
That's okay with us.
I had a whale get on my furniture the other day. Didn't leave a mark. No, he flattened it, but he didn't leave a mark. Just one answer left. That's the goldfish.
They shed.
They shed. There is nothing worse than a shedding goldfish, I might add, Betsy. Shed. If it's there, you got it all. If not, third strike. Fixin's got a chance to steal. Shed! $87 up there for you, Lita.
Okay, they dig holes.
They dig
holes.
All right.
Cats and dogs both.
If that's there, my love, you get the $87. If not, Brad and his family get it. They dig holes. Number six. Two things. $147 there, please. $12. Let's go. Come on. You're handsome, but you're not allowed to do that, huh? Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers are on the board. Here's the question. Name a nationality with a reputation for having hot tempers.
Italians.
Italians.
We'll play, Richard.
Every game is played. They have no shame at all, these people. Italian.
Okay.
La, la, la. Really, what pets do you have, by the way?
We don't have any. We have a son.
We have fish.
Oh, we have fish.
There you are.
I forgot about them.
You forgot about your fish on television?
I would like to forget about our fish altogether.
Really? I do. I just got rid of my aquarium. They drove me bananas.
Yeah, I think we will, too.
Yeah, I cooked them. They're very nice. little zucchini. Yeah.
I'm going to say Germans.
Germans.
Good answer.
That's an okay with a reputation for having hot tempers. All Deutsch! Oh, not there. First strike. Well, Doc...
I think one nationality that's known for having hot tempers are the Irish.
Oh, yes. The Irish. They'll punch you out for looking at you, and then they'll help you get well, the Irish.
Yeah.
This is true. What do you think, Don?
One place I'd never really want to visit. Russia, the Russians.
Russians?
Yes.
Okay. Hot tempers?
Well, I've never...
Probably all that vodka.
Okay. I'll agree with you.
All right, let's take a look.
Okay.
Russia!
Richard, I think this one is obvious. French.
French?
French.
Yeah.
Well, maybe, I've been there, that's why I say
yeah?
It.
No, they are. They are.
Too. He told me too.
They do yell a lot and they toot their horns.
Well, I had a bad experience. I guess that's
what. Did you really? With a Frenchman?
French lady.
French lady.
She got me.
Yeah? Wacko. Yeah, they do. They scream a lot. If it's there, darling, you got it all. And you'll be the champ. She'll play for $10,000. If not, second strike. French! No? I think their reputation is as... Well, no, but I think their reputation is sort of as lovers, you know.
Oh.
Don't you think so?
That's true.
In reality, it's not true.
Let's see. I've been to Mexico, so I'll say the Mexicans.
Okay. Yeah. If it's there, you're the champ. If not, they get a chance to steal. Mexico! They played every question. Little did we know when that $12 came up, did we know that that was going to be it. I never even got down to see Shirley. I'm going to go down there and see her. Okay. We do have nice prizes for you, though. Okay. And I hope your tooth gets, you know, well as soon as mine, all right?
Sure.
Robert, thank you. I'm sorry. We got nice prizes. Take care. Glenn, I did meet you, and I never met Shirley. Thank you. Take care. Hi, who's going to play? Go, two people. Who's first?
Good.
Patty and Brad are going for $10,000 right after we watch this. Well done. Money promise?
Sure am.
That's for luck.
Thank
Give
you.
Me 15 seconds, please.
Okay.
Name an organization to which people donate clothing.
The Goodwill.
How long a headache usually lasts?
3 hours.
A spring flower?
Pass.
The spice you use most?
Cinnamon.
Something knives and forks are made of?
Stainless steel.
A spring flower? Oh, is it any flower?
I know.
Okay, here we go.
Okay.
Organization to which people donate clothing. You said? Goodwill. Survey said? How long a headache usually lasts? She said 3 hours. Just enough to get to sleep. Survey said? 13. She passed on the spring flower. Yeah, you couldn't think of a spring flower. So you passed on that. Spice you use most? You said? Cinnamon. Survey said? 25. You got 82. Something knives and forks are made of. Stainless steel was your answer. Survey said? Here's the doctor. 62 points, Doc. It's all you need. I'll ask the same questions. Don't duplicate the answers. You know we're going to wish you luck. Please remind everyone the answers Patty gave us. Give me 20 seconds on the clock, please. Name an organization to which people donate clothing.
Goodwill.
Try again.
Salvation Army.
How long a headache usually lasts?
Half an hour.
A spring flower.
A daisy.
The spice you use most?
Oregano.
Something knives and forks are made of?
Steel.
Try again.
Silver.
Turn around. Right. Organization to which people donate clothing. You said? Salvation Army. The number one answer. Survey said? How long a headache usually lasts? Is this your professional opinion you gave me?
No, just personally.
Oh, all right. You said what? Half an hour. If it's worth 15 points, you got $10,000. Survey said? Zero. 2 hours. 2 hours, number one answer. Spring flower, you asked. You said? Daisy. Tulip was the number one answer, but you still only need 15 points. Survey said? The moment you win, all your patients show up. $10,335. Would you have that? Let's see you there on the field.
big network, the hit show. And the unemployed ice cream truck driver from Ohio.
Meet Michael Larson.
Who took them all for a ride.
Michael says let's go.
I would consider this one of the most significant incidents in game show history.
Find out how contestant Michael Larson cracked the code.
He was a genius.
And broke the game show bank.
The guy nailed it. He ripped them off for $110,000.
Big Box, the Press Your Luck Scandal. March 16th at 9 Eastern. Only on Game Show Network.
Stop!
Good.